Hello, fellow tricksters and their victims. Lokamander here. And today, well, it's been a long time coming. I'm going to be playing Fallout 3. I have played this game so many times. I'm going to do it again. And this time, when there are big decisions to make, I am going to leave it to you, the viewers, to decide which decision I make. Alright, let's get started. I'm gonna sit through this because I really like this.
I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart.
Yeah, I can't sing worth a damn.
In my heart, I have but one.
I really do enjoy the old music.
And that one is you. No other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of.
So I doubt there are many people who haven't heard of Fallout games, but for those who haven't, basically there was a nuclear. There was basically a nuclear apocalypse, we'll just put it that way. And the game is basically set after said nuclear apocalypse happened. And there were these vaults built.
War never changes.
For people to.
Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything. From God to justice to simple psychotic rage.
All true. Facts.
In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself no longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation. But it was not, as some had predicted, the end of the world. Instead, the apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history. For man had succeeded in destroying the world, but war never changes. In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as vaults.
That's better.
But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them. All except those in Vault 101. For on that fateful day, when fire rained from the sky, the giant steel door of Vault 101 slid closed and never reopened. It was here you were born. It is here you will die. Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters and no one ever leaves.
Supposedly. Anyone who's played this game before, though, knows that's a crock of shit.
Let's see. Are you a boy or a girl?
I've always gone with a boy. I wonder if I should pick a girl for a change. I'll stick with boy this time.
It's a boy.
Let me know in the comments if you'd like me to
We've
mention
got a son,
a girl.
A beautiful, healthy baby boy.
Oh, James, we did it. A son, a beautiful son.
You've got a bright future ahead of you, son. I'm sure of it. Look at you. Look at you. Hi there. I'm your daddy, little guy. Daddy. You're going to need a name.
Props to William Neeson.
Your mother and I have been talking. What do you think about...
I love Neeson's range. He can either sound like a total badass that you don't want to fuck with, or he can sound like the grandfatherly figure that everyone wants as their grandpa. Alright. Let's see, what name should I go with? I think I'll just stick with Loki. What the? I don't want all caps. It's stupid.
That's a good name, don't you think? Fits you perfectly. Looks like they've finished the gene projection. Let's see what you'll look like when you're all grown up.
Let's see. Yeah, I'm gonna stick with Caucasian this time. Mainly because I pretty much always do. I like to make the character look like me if I can. As close to me as I can. I'm not going through all that. Now, they don't have my exact eye color. My eye color is more brown with a hint of basil. Alright, so I'm gonna start out of order here, because I'm gonna. Let's see. Where in the hell? Wait, I can't change the hair. I swore you could change the hair. Oh, there we go. There we go, there's my haircut. I wouldn't say my eyebrows are exactly thick. But they're not small. Let's see. Up there, maybe? Hmm. characters, my nose. I haven't played big nose. Most of my family does. That makes sense since we're Polacks. Kinda. I guess that's as close as I'm gonna get. Oh, I can change this. Okay. That looks closer to my hairstyle. And I'm actually currently pretty clean shaven. I hit the wrong button.
You're going to look a lot like your dad.
In what way?
Oh, very strapping.
It's a big world out there, son, full of all sorts of people. What about you? What kind of person are you going to be? You're just
James?
Catherine?
James.
Catherine! She's in cardiac James. Arrest. Start compressions. James. Get the baby out of here. Move! Move! 1,000. 2,000. Come on.
This
hang on, Catherine.
City.
Hang on.
Okay? Just remember one thing. We need a doctor, not a dead
one. This one's on the house.
Fail to meet my expectations
no.
And there will be no repercussions.
James and his cheery charity.
Look straight into the light and make it poise and listen when I will feel just like so something you get used to down here. Come on over here, son. Come on. Walk to Daddy. There you go. My goodness. Just a year old and already walking like a pro. Your mother would have been so proud. Listen, kiddo. I know you don't like it when Daddy leaves you alone. But I need you to take care of yourself for a minute. You just stay here while Daddy runs to his office. You'll be okay, pal. I'll be back in a bit.
I don't feel like just sitting here. I'm gonna go exploring! Okay, I'll get to that. But first, I wanna look at this. Teddy bear! No, give me the teddy bear. Ah, fuck it.
Baby.
Okay, so... I know what all this is, so I'm just gonna skip right to the end. Alright, so I have 5 points that I can pass around. I know everything's pretty even. There we go. Yeah, I have the teddy bear.
You are quite the little explorer, aren't you?
I know.
Serves me right for trying to pin you in. Come on over here.
Damn straight.
I want to show you something. See that? It was your mother's favorite passage. It's from the Bible. Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. She always loved that. All right, come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amada wants to play.
Amada, I forgot her name. It's been that long since I played this.
These experiments
don't
are
a waste of money. We experiment to prepare. We prepare to survive. Of course I miss her. I miss her.
Surprise! Stanley, you turned the lights on too fast. You blinded the poor kid.
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday!
Can you believe it? He is growing up so fast.
Happy birthday, pal. I can't believe you're already 10. I'm so proud of you. If only your mother...
Congratulations, young man. I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I? Down here in Vault 101, when you turn 10, well, you're ready to take on your first official Vault responsibilities. So here you are. As overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000. Get used to it. You'll be getting your first work assignment tomorrow.
Yeah, and the Pip-Boy never comes off.
Enjoy your
I want to know how bathing
only
works
10
with
once,
Pip-Boy.
So have fun.
Is it water pump or something? Not to mention, you can't exactly clean
Happy birthday! We really surprised you, didn't we? Your dad was afraid you were onto us. But I told him not to worry. You're so easy to fool.
So here's what I'm gonna do. Alright. Get out some dice here. These aren't really big decisions, so I'm gonna make them myself. Basically, I'm gonna use a formula of D4 minus 1. Unless, of course, it comes up as one, then it's just one. Anyways. Okay, so number 3. Oh, man. So I'm gonna be a dick.
Shut up. And it isn't my fault that Butch and Wally are here. Your dad said we had to invite them. Never mind them. Time for your present. What do you think I got you? Go on, try to guess.
Okay, I'm gonna do it again. Because I'm just gonna have some fun with this. Okay, so... that comes up as a 3. Minus 1 makes it 2.
Gross! I didn't think you even liked girls. And you know what I mean, before you say something rude about me.
What,
I guess maybe
I
should give this to someone else.
Somebody in real
life, likes
Grognak
the Barbarian better than mean Christine. The question is, how could you tell the difference?
Oh man, you got a Pip-Boy. I wish I was 10. Hey, thanks for inviting me. Really cool party and everything. I know that, Butch and I give you a hard time, but you don't take that seriously, right? Anyway, happy birthday and everything. I better get back to, you know.
What, are you two best friends now?
Happy birthday!
Hey, Wally,
happy birthday, Sonny!
Yeah, Paul.
Happy birthday, Sonny!
Oh, you're not gonna say
anything. Your new best friend.
Who do you mean, Dorkface here?
I hope you appreciate the effort Amara put into this party. She really seems to like you, for some reason.
Okay, so there's 2 options, so I'm basically just going to do evens or odds. Evens, I'll do the first one. Odds, I'll do the second one. Evens. Okay.
Don't presume too much on her friendship, young man. I'm still the overseer, and I'm still in charge of this vault and everyone in it.
Happy
enjoying
birthday,
yourself? Are you having a nice party? 10 years old. My, my, my. Seems like only yesterday that your daddy came. Goodness, listen to me ramble. You're waiting for your present, aren't you?
I almost slipped up there, honey. Okay, so three options again. So that's two. Oh, so I'm gonna be nice to her.
Fiddlesticks. What 10-year-old doesn't like presents? I was 10 once, believe it or not. My goodness, the vault was practically crowded back then. Not like today. So few young people now. But here I am rambling on again, and you listening so politely.
Indeed.
Here you go. A nice sweet roll that I baked for you just this morning. And it's all for you. No sharing required today.
Attention, everyone. It's time to cut the cake.
Andy, wait.
How do you like that Pip-Boy, son? Fit all right and everything?
Yes, I'm going to do this for all of them. Oh, I'm being nice again, apparently.
As a matter of fact, I did. I'm glad you like it. Some may think the A-series is a bit basic, but I've always preferred them for their reliability.
Oh my god, I'm gonna be a dick again. That's really, really interesting.
Sure, most people don't give a thought to their Pip-Boy as long as it keeps working. Well, anyway, I got this for your birthday. It isn't much, and you probably already have one. But there you go. Happy birthday.
I feel like a dick now.
Nonsense. People always enjoy my little speeches. Besides, that friend of yours...
I'm hungry, and that stupid robot destroyed the cake. Give me that sweet roll you got from old Lady Palmer.
I'm debating because I kind of just want to tell him fuck you, but... Okay, so that's not option one.
Mrs. Palmer said I didn't have to share. Who's talking about sharing, moron? I want the whole thing. Now, are you gonna give me that sweet roll, or am I gonna have to give you a knuckle sandwich?
All right. Okay.
Gah, I don't want your nerd cooties. You're gonna be sorry you did that. We'll see how tough you are later when the grown-ups aren't around.
Butch's such an idiot. Just ignore him.
Okay.
I know. He thinks he's so tough. One of these days, we'll figure out a way to get him back, okay?
Okay. I like that.
Nice Pip-Boy. What is that?
So, what do you think we should call our guest?
You're coming, Stanley.
Hey, how about some bowler? This party's pretty good, I guess. For a little kid. Balloons, party hats. Not as cool as my party, though. Remember how my dad got Andy to do magic tricks? And we all played Hunt the Mutant in the atrium? Oh, right. You weren't invited to my party. Too bad, man. It was really fun.
Get it?
What a dick.
Who wants to go around all day being called a voice?
Enjoying yourself?
I think you really are as dumb as you look.
Enjoying yourself?
I'll send him
happy birthday, Sonny.
You always had good ideas.
Hey, that was Jonas on the intercom. He and I have been cooking up a little surprise present. Jonas is waiting for you downstairs on the reactor level. Go ahead. I don't think anyone will mind if you slip out for a few minutes.
Yes, you can
right?
Yeah.
Right.
Anyway, I got one.
I'm glad
the
you
Mackers.
Could make it.
Super cool, right?
Jeez, Wally, who's the head of the gang? You or me?
How are you enjoying
no way.
The party, Mrs.
Happy birthday, dearie. My goodness, I hope I didn't miss the party. They sure did. My, my. 10 years old already? Why, I can remember helping your dad change your diapers. And now look at you, a great big grown-up 10-year-old with your very own Pip-Boy. Since this was such a special occasion, do you know what I did? I wrote you a poem just for you.
Okay.
I hope you like it.
Thanks. Who doesn't want to get a poem for their birthday, especially at 10?
Of course. Run along now, dearie, and have yourself a wonderful birthday.
Palmer, I help with the decorations, you know.
All right. Oh, really? They're lovely.
Got to follow the flashing arrow. I went the wrong way.
Happy birthday!
You have nothing worthwhile. Your life is meaningless, old man.
What are you doing down here, young man? I thought kids weren't allowed down on the reactor level.
Right. Okay.
You sure are. Pip-Boy and everything. Look at that. If you can wait just one more minute, I think your dad will want to give you the surprise himself.
I don't want to wait. I don't like waiting. Hi, Dad. I'm gonna just kind of run away here for a bit. Okay.
Are you ready for your surprise?
Okay, this is another easy one. Odds or evens? And it's odd, so I'm gonna say I don't like surprises.
Since when? Regardless, I think you'll like this one. You're getting older, and you've got your Pip-Boy. I figure you're old enough for this, too. Your own BB gun. It's a little old, but it should work perfectly. Jonas found it down here. It was in pretty rough shape. Took us a good 3 months to find the parts to get it working again. You know how tough it is to find a spring that small? Good thing Butch misplaced that switchblade of his. So, what do you think? Want to give it a try?
Okay, another evens or odds. Even.
We sure can't, unless we want the overseer beating down our door. Jonas and I have found a place, though. Come on.
All right. Yep, okay. I know how to use this. Oh, I totally missed.
Just aim and shoot. You're fine.
Yay!
Good work. That's one less rad roach to deal with. Let's get a picture together. Capture the moment.
Sounds
hey, Jonas, get a picture of me with the big game hunter.
Hey, shoot at the targets, okay?
course it is. It's the greatest toy ever.
Smile.
Boys and girls have different parts.
What is her problem anyway? So, I'm the overseer's daughter. So what? That like, I get any kind of special treatment.
Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. As far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old boy. So yes, you have to go to class to take your GOAT exam. Go on now. You've got a GOAT to take.
All right. So, that's number two.
No, you are not. Really. When I started studying medicine, one of the first things I learned was how to spot a kid playing sick to get out of taking a test. You'll do fine. It's not so bad. Everyone has to take it when they're 16. I had to, you have to, and so does everyone else. And most everyone makes it through without a scratch.
Okay.
Hey, it's not my call. Those are the rules. You're 16 now, so this year you take the GOAT. Come on, it's not so bad. Everyone has to take it. You'll do just fine.
So do I eventually have to take a sheep test too?
The Generalized Occupational Aptitude Test, GOAT. Everyone here in the vault takes it when they're 16. Helps to figure out what sort of a job you'll have here in Vault 101 when you get a bit older. So, pay attention and try not to fall asleep. You know what the overseer says? We're born in the vault, we die in the vault. Each is tested to determine their abilities, that they may work for the betterment of all vault residents. Huh. Sound familiar?
Sounds like... Sounds like dangerous propaganda to me.
That's what the overseer says, isn't it?
You know,
he's not about to let anyone else
say,
in, so I guess that's how it'll have to be. You're here now, and it's a hell of a lot better than being up there. All your mother and I ever wanted was for you to be safe, and you're safe here. That's not the way it works. And it won't do to go around asking questions like that, especially not around the overseer. I want to tell you something now. It's important, so listen closely. This place, this vault, it's not perfect, I know, but it is your home. You're safe here.
Is it though?
Stay on the overseer's good side, and you always will be. You understand?
Sure.
You need to appreciate all you have, because what's up there on the outside, that's not the life I want for you. And it's not what your mother wanted for you either.
Oh, shit. There was two other options. I'm not actually going to roll this time. I'm just going to say bye, Dad, because this is dragging.
Take care, son. Now get out of here, and good luck.
All right. I'm going to grab this.
Good morning. Stopped in to see the old man before class, eh?
That's gonna come in
handy. Morning, Jonas.
Morning, Doc. How's things?
I was just. You better stay away. I don't want you to catch what I've got.
I just like to keep an eye on.
No problem. How considerate.
My report ready.
Get out of my way, you stupid tunnel snakes.
Let me know if they're running.
I can show you a real tunnel snake, Amata.
God, Butch!
Tunnel snakes rule!
Okay, so this is just going to be straight up D4, no minus one.
That's us, and we rule! No one messes with the tunnel snakes, or they have to answer to Butch and Wally. You don't want to be on their bad sides. Trust me. None of your business, because Butch said so. And what Butch says goes. Tunnel snakes rule! Because he's my pal, my brother. All us tunnel snakes are brothers. Birth to earth, womb to tomb. Mostly because tunnel snakes rule. Can't think of anything. Butch says this little bitch is blabbing to her daddy about us tunnel snakes. We can't have that. Because we're the tunnel snakes, and we rule. Much later. Tunnel snakes rule.
Why don't you just leave me alone?
What are you gonna do?
Stupid tunnel snakes. Immature assholes, if you ask me. Why won't they leave me alone? It's not my fault my father's the overseer. I don't care about their stupid gang. Can you talk to them? Maybe Butch will listen to you. Please? Bunch of idiots, if you ask me. They think they're so tough with their gang. All they ever do is hang around and cause trouble. They've got it in for me because my father is the overseer. Like, that's my fault. Thanks.
Daddy's girl, daddy.
Hey, look. It's Smart Mouth. Afraid I ain't got time for your fancy words right now. So beat it.
Dropped my die. Okay.
None of your business, kid. Get out of here before you get hurt. If you mess with the tunnel snakes, you're asking for it. Got me?
Alright, how many options have we this time? Four again. Okay.
And who are you? Her boyfriend? Ha! Keep talking like that, boy, and we'll send you back to your daddy with a few broken bones for him to fix.
You know, Butch, it's not very smart to threaten to hurt the son of the doctor. Doctor could always make sure that you don't walk again the next time you come in for a checkup. Anyways, okay.
Maybe you're right.
Woo!
We can deal with her later.
Girl.
Come on, tunnel snakes. This little bitch isn't worth our time. Whatever you say, Butch.
Leave me alone, you little spaz.
Tunnel snakes rule.
Fine, let's go.
I've got this headache that just won't go away. Even with the pills you gave me last.
Thanks for getting rid of them. Assholes. I don't know why they won't leave me alone. Just because my father's the overseer, I guess? Idiots.
Hey, Susie, what's new?
Oh, not much. Our heater's on the fritz again.
Well, you made it. All set for the goat? Trust me, it really isn't that bad. Just something everybody has to go through.
All right. Another D4 minus one. Three.
Listen. I like your dad. I might even like you if I wasn't your teacher. So here's what I'm going to do. If you want to skip the test, just tell me how you want it to come out, and I'll take care of it for you.
Really? Dice have spoken.
Good for you. Don't worry, you'll do fine. As soon as everyone's found a seat, we'll get started.
I'm gonna sit right in the front here.
Well, now that everyone has managed to find the classroom, we can finally get started. No talking, and keep your eyes to yourselves. Yes, I'm talking to you, Mr. Deloria.
Sure thing, Mr. Brotch.
Unless anyone else has an insightful comment, let's get started. Question one. A frenzied vault scientist runs up to you and yells, "I'm going to put my quantum harmonizer in your photonic resonation chamber." What's your response?
So there's four options, so that's perfect. A straight D4 roll. Number three.
Question two. While working as an intern in the clinic, a patient with a strange infection in his foot stumbles through the door. The infection is spreading at an alarming rate, but the doctor has stepped out for a while. What do you do?
All right. Okay. Bit boring, but okay.
Question three. You discover a young boy lost in the lower levels of the vault. He's hungry and frightened, but also appears to be in possession of stolen property. What do you do?
All right. Okay.
Question four. Congratulations. You've made one of the Vault 101 baseball teams. Which position do you prefer?
Designated hitter.
Question five. Your grandmother invites you to tea, but you're surprised when she gives you a pistol and orders you to kill another Vault resident. What do you do?
All right. Doesn't sound like me, but okay.
Question six. Old Mr. Abernathy has locked himself in his quarters again, and you've been ordered to get him out. How do you proceed?
Walk away and let the old coot rot.
Question seven. Oh no. You've been exposed to radiation, and a mutated hand has grown out of your stomach. What's the best course of treatment? Question 8. A fellow Vault 101 resident is in possession of a Grognak the Barbarian comic book, issue number 1. You want it. What's the best way to obtain it?
Steal the comic book at gunpoint.
Question 9. You decide it would be fun to play a prank on your father. You enter his private restroom when no one is looking and... Question 10. Who is indisputably the most important person in Vault 101? He who shelters us from the harshness of the atomic wasteland, and to whom we owe everything we have, including our lives.
Okay, this is a very difficult one. Definitely need the die for this one.
Pencils down, people. That's it. The infamous goat. I'm sure most of you didn't find it so bad. Others, well, there are always openings in the maintenance department. Don't forget to hand in your test before you leave. You don't want to know what happens to people who fail the goat. You can have the rest of the day off to celebrate or to pray, as the situation warrants.
I'm taking a coffee mug.
Get out of my face.
Here you are, Mr. Looks like the diner's going to get a new fry cook. I'll just say this once. Hold the mustard, extra pickles.
Okay, then.
Listen, I was just as obnoxious at your age. I didn't take the goat seriously. Look where I ended up. Just between you and me, the whole test is a joke. If you don't like the results, I can make your goat come out any way you want. Just let me know.
Let's see. So, let's take away melee weapons. Put it in barter. I can upgrade repair later. Let's put this in lockpick. Medicine, I can upgrade that later as well. Let's see, let's go with speech. And actually, I'm going to take barter and put it into sneak instead. Can you tell I enjoy playing rogues in D&D?
Thank God that's over. Come on, let's go get some light.
Alright. And another flash forward. Even an A. That is Dr. Rain here to save you now.
Is he helping you get back to work? Selfish and insubordinate. Just
wake up!
You need to
come
know
on, wake up!
Things. I'm not going to be around to hold your hand forever.
Come on! You've got to wake up!
Okay.
You've got to get out of here. Your dad is gone, and my father's men are looking for you. You don't understand. Your dad somehow opened the main door and left the vault. My father, I've never seen him so angry. Listen to me. If the guards find you, they'll kill you.
Okay.
I thought so too, but it's true. He's gone, and Jonas is dead, and now they're looking for you.
What's this reminder for? Oh, okay. I shall do that later. All right. Dropped my damn controller. Alright, so I am going to come back to this in just a moment. You won't even notice that I am gone. And I'm back. Oh, and I forgot my headphones. Alright, so. Alright.
I don't know! Some of my father's men? Look, that doesn't matter right now. You need to worry about getting out of here alive. Revenge will have to wait.
All right.
Oh, so you don't trust me now? Thanks a lot. You think it was easy for me to get here with the rad roaches and security all over the place?
I never said that. Jeez.
Your sense of self-preservation never fails to rise to the surface. Lucky for you, I have a plan. I can help
Chill.
You follow your dad and escape from the vault.
She is not my biggest fan right now.
Listen. There's a secret tunnel that leads directly from my father's office to the exit. You'll have to hack the computer in his office to open it. Use these to get into his office. That's how I always get in.
Amata, you naughty girl.
Oh, one more thing. I stole my father's pistol. I hope you won't need it, but you'd better take it just in case. Okay, I'll try to meet you at the exit. Watch out for security. Good luck.
Alright, before I get going.
I'll meet you at the vault door if I can, but don't wait for me.
Yeah, you never know. Could sell those later. Just for giggles.
There he is. Hold it right there. Criminy, more roaches. There's more where that came from. Gotcha now. Too bad it had went this way. But here's our order.
You gotta help me! My mom's trapped in there with the rat roaches! No, I can't go back in there. It's dark, and there's rat roaches.
What a coward.
No, I mean, it's not the dark. It's the rat roaches. I can't stand them. I tried to get back in to get her. I really did. But I couldn't. You gotta help me. She's not gonna last much longer in there. Can't you hear her screaming?
No, I really can't. Okay.
Oh my...
Stop it!
Where is it? I don't know where I'm going. Oh, here we go. And I think I have some kill.
See? Just go away and leave me alone.
Okay, you want to be like that. good water on you, huh? Alright. Ooh, more vodka. Switch to the TV.
Any resident found outside his or her quarters will be dealt with severely.
And
that is all.
Been so long. That's what I fucking thought.
All residents of Vault 101 are hereby confined to their quarters. Rat roach infestation is under control. Do not interfere with vault security personnel. Any resident found outside his or her quarters will be dealt with severely.
Son, I just want to talk to you for a minute.
There's more over here. There's more over here.
That's enough excitement for one day. Ah, young sir. How very good to see you again. I do suppose.
You were never here.
I always did like you, Officer Gomez.
Oh, you're lucky it was me who found you. The others won't be so forgiving. I don't know what you're up to, and I don't want to know. Just clear out of here, and I'll pretend I never saw you.
All right. Good, because I didn't want number three.
It's a real shame it's come to this. I can't believe what they did to Jonas. Officer Mack was just out of control. But you're a good kid. You didn't do anything to deserve this. Go find your dad if you can.
So, Officer Matt killed Jonas.
It's our only chance, don't you see? We're getting out of here, just like the doctor. I'm not gonna let anyone stop us. It's me.
Tom, be careful! Tom, no!
Ooh, scrap metal. That comes in handy. Most of this I will probably be using, but most of this I will. Yeah, my aim sucks. That's why I need the bat. There we go. Ooh, tinted reading glasses. Yeah.
I hope you're here to turn yourself in, young man. You're already in enough trouble as it is.
I've already avenged Jonas and killed him.
I place the good of the vault above everything, even my own paternal feelings. We must not allow sentiment to cloud our judgment. But I admire your protective instincts. Very well. I give you my word that Amata will not suffer further because of your actions. Now then, if you really care about Amata, you will see how dangerous your father's actions were. Hand over your weapons, and put an end to this dangerous situation. There is no need to join your father as a traitor to the vault. Oh, is that all?
Is there anything else I can get you while you're here? You'll get nothing from me. I'll die before I see the safety of the vault compromised again.
Okay.
Save your sanctimony. The world is a dangerous place, and I make no apologies for doing whatever it takes to keep the vault safe. Guards, help me! He's here, don't... Let him get away.
Thank you. I told you my father wasn't himself. I don't know what he might have done if you hadn't come along. You'd better get out of here. I'll try to meet you at the vault door. If I don't make it, good luck.
Yummy. Okay, anyways. Never know when I'll need more bugs. Second try. Thank you.
open the door! My God, I almost didn't believe it was possible.
All right. Okay.
No, you didn't need me. If anyone can survive out there, it's you.
All right.
It's tempting, but my place is here. The vault needs me more than you do. I'm the only one who has a chance to talk some sense into my father. Listen, if you do catch up with your dad, tell him I'm sorry for you know, Jonas and my father and everything. Goodbye.
Stop, in the name of the overseer!
I chose a bad time to do that. Let's see. Attack skills. Yeah, I'll leave it as is. Name. Nope, I'll just leave it as that. So bright. Yay! You get 17. Definitely want to put some towards sneak. And walk. I'll put some towards medicine too. With this one.
Straight. I told him what was what. Well, the winners, the losers, the movers, the shakers. So if you see James out there,
have yourself a nice visit, partner.
Show him that you're on the outside.
Okay.
You always fight partner. The good fight. Hey, in case a light bulb just started glowing over your head, you can flick the switch and forget about it. You're not getting into that vault. In there sure as hell doesn't want what you're selling. And no.
Name's Lucas Sims, town sheriff, and mayor too when the need arises.
Next time, this is $3.
Friendly and well-mannered. I think we're gonna get along just fine. You treat my people nice, and you're welcome to stay as long as you'd like.
My dad got caught in the keyboard. Let's try this again.
I'm glad we understand each other. Now, is there something I can help you with?
All right. Six options. So, I'm going to use a D6 this time. Option two.
Sure thing, partner. What do you need to find?
D6 again.
Moira sells all kinds of stuff at her place. Crater Side Supply. Take a guess where it is. Nope. Sorry. I got enough fires to put out in this place that I don't have time to keep tabs on every visitor. I'd ask around town. What about it?
Oh, shit. That's a three.
I don't trust any of the locals to tinker with it. Besides, most people don't even realize it's still a threat. And hell, Cromwell and those crazies from the Church of Adam, they worship the damn thing. Why? You think you got the know-how to disarm it? For good? Enjoy your stay in Megaton. Don't get into any trouble, and we'll go on pretending we're friends. Carry on.
Hey there.
Each morning, a missionary of a type, neon sign.
Every eye shall be blind with his glory. Every ear shall be stricken deaf to hear the thunder of the storm.
And create your gated savages holler from the bamboo tree. That civilization is a thing for me to see.
So bongo, 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 I don't wanna leave the Congo. No. Bingo, bango, bungle, I'm so happy in the jungle, I refuse to go. Don't want no bright lights, false teeth, doorbells, landlords, I make it clear.
That no matter how they coax him,
I'll stay. I don't particularly right like the design. So
I look through a magazine the missionary's wife conceals.
Magazine? What happened?
I see how people who are civilized bung you with automobiles.
You know you can get hurt that way, Dad?
At the movies they have got to pay many coconuts to see.
What do they see, Donnie?
Uncivilized.
It also doesn't seem very safe.
So
bongo, bongo, bongo. All right. Bingo, bango, bongo, he's so happy in the jungle, he refused to go.
Children of the Atom. Penthouse, bathtub, streets, cars, taxis, noise in my ears.
So no matter how they coax him,
I'll stay right here.
Nope.
They're hurrying like savages to get aboard an iron train.
The Kringle-Lingle-Hoola-Humble Express.
And though it's smoky and it's crowded, they're too civilized to complain.
Along the Norfosahi Minor, when they've got 2 weeks vacation, they hurry to vacation ground.
What do they do, Johnny?
They swim and they fish, but that's what I do all year round.
So, bongo, 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 I don't want to leave the bongo.
Don't want no jailhouse.
Shotgun.
Fish hooks.
Dog club.
I got my spears.
So no matter how they coax him,
I'll stay right here.
They have things like the atom bomb.
Here we go, Moriarty.
I'll stay where I am.
Civilization. I'll stay right here.
Moriarty, silly.
Can I do for you, Daddy-O? Dang.
I told you, Bob, it ain't the radio.
Hey, Smoothskin, you need something? A drink, maybe? Anything? Anything at all?
Hey, this will get interesting.
Wait, you're not gonna hit me? Yell at me? Not even berate me a little bit? I'm used to every asshole Smoothskin in this town giving me shit just because I look like a corpse. I'm glad to see that there are a few worthwhile people around here. Listen, Moriarty'd have my head if he caught me selling at a discount. But for you, I'll risk it.
Yay! Okay, so this is, 6 here.
Oh yeah, I do remember a guy like that. Honestly, I usually keep my head down. I tend to get smacked around if I look customers in the eyes. But talk to Moriarty, he'll know more.
I'm not gonna get a roll on this one, I'm just gonna do this.
Sorry, Smoothskin. Yeah. I can't take the risk. Moriarty will beat the shit out of me for even talking to you.
The Enclave Station comes in fine. Galaxy News. Their signal's been shit lately.
Colin Moriarty, at your service. Welcome to Moriarty's. My saloon, my home, my slice of heaven in this backwoods little burg. You've got the caps. My God, it's you. The little baby boy all grown up. Persistent little bastard, ain't ya? Then and now, it would seem. It's been a long time, kid. Oh, your daddy passed through here already. Here and gone. Got what he came for and then left. I'm assuming you'll do the same, correct? Is that what your father told you? That you were born in that hole? That he was born there as well? Oh, the lies we tell to those we love. Your father brought you to the vault right after you were born. To keep you safe, you see. I remember it well, you stayed in my saloon after all. That's right. Your father, his Brotherhood of Steel friend, and you, the suckling babe with nary a tit to suckle. Sorry about your mom, truly. But life goes on. Daddy lied. Life's full of little disappointments. And now you're all grown up and wondering where he's gone to.
Yep.
Today's weather excessively violent with a chance of this element.
see. You know, I heard about the brainwashing that goes on down there. From some other fella, escaped. Oh, 5 years back. All hail the Overseer. We're born in the vault, we die in the vault, and all that other assorted lunacy. Kid, you've got better programming than our own Deputy Weld. You best wise up quick. Wouldn't want anyone taking advantage of you, hmm?
I like option one, but I'm gonna roll for it again.
Did he?
Ooh.
Well, our time together was brief, but that is the way of it. When a bond is forged, little else matters, hmm? Well, he did come through here, but he left. I'm truly sorry. But maybe you can catch up to him. He headed southeast into the city. Said he needed information from those loonies at the station. You know, Galaxy News Radio. What there is of it.
I'm just...
And so now we part.
Cool.
My, my. Just when I had all but given up hope. My dear boy. I'm very happy to meet your acquaintance. I am Mr. Burke.
How do you keep...
And you, well, you are not a resident of this putrescent cesspool.
Putrescent?
And makes you a rather valuable
individual. That's actually a word I haven't heard before. I am always excited to learn new words. A few seconds, folks. Going the process of decay. Okay. Okay.
Finally, someone with a modicum of civility and common sense. I represent certain interests, and those interests view this town, this megaton, as a blight on a burgeoning urban landscape. You have no connections here, no interest in this cesspool's affairs or fate. You could assist us in erasing this little accident off the map.
And this is where I'm going to end the video, folks. It's up to you. What am I going to tell Mr. Burke here? Let me know in the comments. And if you enjoyed the video, please consider leaving a like, and if you aren't already, subscribe. And I'll see you in the next one. Stay wicked, everyone.